Hello everybody, once again, it's me. We are at the Pennsy-Wabash Bridge. I'm standing on the Pennsy side. Anybody who's a rail fan knows that these tracks go down pretty far to the northwest. And I don't see myself traveling the entire distance, not on foot anyway. But we're gonna see how far we can go. So ahead of us, that will be the toll road. So we're gonna go ahead and head down in that direction. There are some new signals up there and I don't think that they are active, but I wanna take some film of those signals. I believe I have a video posted of when I was at that bridge. I'm just gonna go ahead and superimpose that video of the Grand Calumet River area prior to the restoration. So I'm gonna try my best to reduce the shakiness as much as I possibly can, if it makes sense to do so. Once again, if you find my videos appalling because of how it shakes, I apologize. If I could find an extra $600-$700 to invest in some equipment that'll help me with gyro stabilization, that's, of course that would happen. But until then, this is all that I got. This is some type of U.S. Customs trading post. Used to be Georgia Pacific, back off of 2nd and Waite. They're very highly secretive about what goes on back here. I've been kicked off of this property a couple of times, but they are able to see me walk up these tracks, but I doubt anybody would be paying attention. So I'm going to keep my distance away from this factory here and stay on the Pennsy side and stay off of the Wabash side, which is, that's the tracks that you see in front of us. That would be the Wabash line, or the ex-Wabash line. Shouldn't be in use. Back at Tolleston Junction, or Tolleston Interlocking, the tracks were not connected. Okay, we've walked a nice amount of yards away. This would be the Gary Sanitation District. These tracks are more difficult to walk now because the timber and the ballast has been replaced. It's a lot deeper than what it used to be. Very difficult to walk down here. You can see on the tracks there's still a lot of roots and stumps. Wabash line over there. The Pennsy in front of me. This is the Gary Sanitation District. A few years ago, this fence in front of us was overgrown. So, feeling a little bit exposed now that all the vegetation has been cut away, but I think I'll be all right. I'm noticing that not all the rail has been replaced. This you still got some of the old timber down here, and these rails have not been tampered with at all. The walk has certainly become a lot easier. You can see the difference between the gravel and the ties. Very interesting. I don't think these tracks here have been replaced. But this vegetation has been cut down. I've never walked on these tracks before in my life because the vegetation was so thick, you know. You also got to be careful walking back here. There's a lot of wildlife, deer, stray dogs maybe. And that wonderful Gary Sanitation smell. Nothing like the smell of storm water in the early afternoon. Goodness gracious. And trust me, in the summertime, that smell is a whole lot worse. We're approaching the signal 4436. A lot of Gary Sanitation District traffic going on. Those are gonna be the vehicles that you see driving by me while I do this video. But here we are. Signal 4436. This is a brand new signal. I don't know if there ever used to be a signal here back in the day or not, But this signal, as far as I'm concerned, is brand new and has been installed within the last year. Once again, that's the Gary Sanitation District. Now over here, these would be big old trees. And they've cleared all of that up. All of this. This would be a big old hill back here. And like I said, I feel a little bit exposed because of the Gary Sanitation District being back here. I don't know if any security is going to be called on me or not. I'm going to try to hang around until they kick me out of here. That is I-90, ladies and gentlemen. We're going to be passing under that. We're going to get away from this sanitation district property because I don't want anybody getting suspicious of my presence here. This is what I mean by wildlife. Some type of hoof creature has been walking around here. More than likely some deer. These are fairly fresh. Probably come through here earlier in the morning. Like I said, it can be a dangerous situation messing around with deer. Deer can harm you and possibly kill you if threatened. Don't really take much to threaten the deer. Trying to be as careful as I can. Here we are at the toll road. Not newly remodeled, but fairly recently remodeled within the last 10 years. This is a spot that I used to come to back in the day. I used to sit on this hill right here in front of us. Just sit here and watch the sugar train go by. Sometimes I was staying right here in this exact spot, watch the sugar train pass on the Wabash side. Here we are on the Wabash side, Pennsy side over there, Wabash side over here. This is under the toll road. You can see back there, the Wabash tracks have been ripped up beyond this bridge. That is the Grand Calumet River back there by that bridge. Here we are on the other side of I-90. On the north side of I-90. That facility right there in the distance will be the old Ambridge factory, which is still active. I don't know exactly what they do out there anymore. I don't think it's a bridge company anymore. We're at the Grand Calumet River. And I can confirm that this bridge, the Wabash Bridge here, has been completely redone. Completely. What's odd is this bridge is wide enough to hold two track beds. There's only one track bed, and I don't know if you all can see ahead, but the original line or the original tracks used to be dead straight ahead of us right there has been ripped up completely. And it bends off to the side there, and I'm assuming that's where trains get to Pine Junction on their way to Kirkyard. On that side of us, that is the Pennsy Bridge, and yes, we are going to be going over there. I just wanted to take a little walk over this bridge here. Let's show you all what it looks like with the remodeling, what has been going on out here the past couple of years. Very interesting stuff. Actually quite happy to see that this bridge was redone because it was in dire straits, and I will post a video of what this bridge used to look like and superimpose it over here so that you all can, you know, get a better idea of what has changed and what hasn't. North Clock Road would be straight ahead of us. I don't know why this shit was out of focus. North Clock Road would be straight ahead of us. And I don't know if I want to walk all the way down there or not to get to Pine Junction, because from here, it's a very, very nice walk. A whole lot of vegetation has been cleared back here. A lot of it. And we're back. Who knows how old these bridges are? They look like to be 20s or 30s era bridges. Possibly could be older than that. This is what the new Wabash Bridge looks like, newly remodeled. Everything is poured concrete. It used to be timber pilings, now they're concrete pilings there. Very, very interesting. Some beaver activity going on. Look at this, Pennsylvania Railroad era bridges. Almost want to be 100% sure these are Pennsylvania Railroad era bridges. Got 501. Let's walk over here to the other bridge. None of these tracks have been replaced. They just ripped up just a portion of them. These are the same tracks that have been here, probably at least since the Amtrak stopped running. I'm not sure about when new track were laid back in the 80s or 90s. Not quite sure about that at all. But yeah, Pennsylvania Railroad bridges. I just want everybody to get a sense of the history of this area as far as the railroad is concerned. Like, Gary, Indiana has a deep, deep railroad history. I know there are a lot of Pennsylvania Railroad fans out there who are interested in, you know, the Fort Wayne line and everything of that nature. We still have standing testaments. Oh, that guy's over there fishing. That's what that truck was there for. I thought he was security. He still might be security, but that guy is definitely over there fishing. Never seen so many people just openly fishing around here. Look, some fishing line right there. I'm not too sure the capability of this bridge to hold a train. Now, this is very sturdily built. Very easily looked like it could have been built to hold the weight of steam locomotives. It just has that style, you know. I mean, none of this shit has been touched in ages, decades, decades. And we have almost made it to the other side. And yes, here we are, folks. Whoa, all kinds of wildlife flying around here. All kinds of birds I've never seen before in my life. Obviously, this was double track, and you can still see where the old track bed used to lay. These rails still cross Fifth Avenue. And this side, with no rails connected to it. Well, I wouldn't kill to see a train come over these bridges again. Very, very cool stuff here. Right in Gary, Indiana. I see another foundation here lying right there. Let's check that out. Yep, I made it across. Folks, they did not do anything on purpose. I mean, on accident back in those days. Maybe the teens and 20s. This looks to be like the foundation for another bridge that no longer sits here. It's the same type of formation going on there as it is with the other one. So there was potentially three bridges here. It's very interesting. Very, very interesting what you find when you look in the vegetation. Now back here on the Wabash side, I never seen any evidence of three bridges. There's one bridge that held two track beds. Never seen any evidence of three bridges. But there could have been a lot of bridges that crossed the Grand Calumet River in this area, to be honest with you. I know potentially could have been three bridges sitting here. There's all kinds of evidence that supports that. Oh, there's some logos over here. Let's go check this out, see what this logo says. Oh, man. This vegetation is very, very dense. I really can't get over there to it. I think it says something about the U.S. Geological Survey. Could have been four track beds laying here at one point in time. Can you all see what that says? I spit on it to kind of get some of that dirt off of there. Can you all make that out? Yes, I'm quite certain there was another bridge that sat here. More than quite certain. And there's a lot of clear land back here that made me suggest that. You still got railroad gravel here. So potentially where some train tracks might have laid. Over here, it's a clearing. Like I said, nothing was done on accident back in the heyday of the railroad. Something used to sit back here. Maybe a switch house, or could have been just a siding that left off of one of these bridges. The rest of the Pennsy line down here, the vegetation is still growing on the railroad tracks. Just like it used to be all the way back down the line towards Fifth Avenue, past Fifth Avenue. Everything looked like this, and the Fifth Avenue side was actually a little bit worse than this as far as weeds are concerned, but these are trees growing in the train tracks now. We can't even see all the way down. Yeah, I'm not going to walk down to North Clark Road. That's a quite bit of ways from here. I have to access that area by car. Some kind of way. I don't know how that's going to happen, but yeah. I'm on the south embankment. And then the north embankment is over there for me to have my conclusion that there used to be another bridge that used to stand here. Upon further inspection, it looks to me like this whole area probably used to be filled with railroad tracks. And I don't know when all of this shit was ripped up. I'm really gonna have to do my research about this area. But yeah, there's nothing but, you know, gravel, and maybe the wind could have thrown the gravel around here, or, you know, people. But there's way too much gravel lying on the ground. This whole area is inundated with gravel, and it just screams out to me there used to be more railroad tracks that used to be around here. I'm really gonna have to dig, and I might have a certain idea about some of it. I found some other, well, there's nothing that I found. I just wanna show you what the top of this berth is. I'm standing on top of a berth, some type of a hill, okay? And, this would be about a 10-foot drop down here. Maybe not 10, but it's quite steep. Like I said, this is the Wabash side that I'm looking at now. The Pennsy side will be over there. Okay. This is the Wabash side. And I used to not be able to see, couldn't see all of this because all of this stuff was just inundated with vegetation, big trees, you know. And you can see some of those trees still standing back there, but this whole entire area was covered. You could not see the other side. You had to come all the way down here, you know, to be able to look, to cross over and see the Pennsy, see the Pennsy tracks. Yeah, but yeah, I'm just looking and I'm like, man, there used to be a lot of tracks around here. This is very interesting. And I wonder why there isn't a lot of history about this place. Because it looks like it used to be the shit, you know? You still got telegraph poles, you know, that still line the side of the tracks here. I'm really surprised that they haven't torn those down. It's 2017, and we still have telegraph poles lining the side of these tracks over here. Okay, you see them? That's one telegraph pole. There's a second telegraph pole. There's a third telegraph pole right here. You know, like, wow. There's still a little bit of this old infrastructure that that's still around here. Just goes to show you, you know, just how important. And there's an old mile marker post now that I see. Right under that telegraph pole right there, you know what I'm saying? Oh man, I don't see a mile marker on there, but I sure would like to know what it was, and probably was a Wabash mile marker. There's more history to be discovered out here, and I'm going to figure this shit out. You know, I don't care how many years it takes for me to find all this information that I need, but I'm going to find it. Definitely am. You know, just kind of a shock, because all my life, you couldn't see a damn thing back here. But now, you know, everything is gone. You can kind of get a better picture of the layout of this place. You know what I'm saying? So if anyone is curious about coming out here, which more than likely you're probably not, this is signal 4435. That's the location where I'm standing, if that will help any of you all out to know what I'm talking about. Signal 4435. South Shore Line. Hello, sweetheart. Hello, baby. Look at this. This is beautiful. Beautiful. The door is long gone. I don't know if the railroad crews removed the door, or scrappers might have removed the door. But look at this thing. Of course, it's some kind of signal box. It's quite different from the one up the line. It's a lot larger. It looks to be like it was more important. This is beautiful. Beautiful infrastructure. Very interesting. We got us another South Shore Line coming. A westbound South Shore Line. Here comes the westbound South Shore. I got to show you this piece of old railroad infrastructure. I know I'm supposed to be gone. Hold on. Let's get over this ridge here. You would think that with all of this remodeling that they're doing around here, that they would get rid of these old signal boxes, you know? Oh, I can't really open it because of the rocks down there. Look at this. That is gorgeous. I don't know what the fuck any of this shit does. But look at that. Look at all that beautiful, beautiful infrastructure. Yes. Yes. I wish I could open this further, but I can't. It's a wasp nest in there. I'm glad it wasn't a wasp in there. I've been a stung ass. I wonder what all these codes mean with all these tags on these wires. And I wonder what controls what. If this seal is broken, the warranty is void. There's usually some type of placards or some type of tag on these signal boxes. I can't find one. It's another piece of infrastructure that I want to show you, but the side of these railroad ties says CR-RR. I wonder what that stands for. Help me know what CR-RR stands for. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, looks like there's been someone here. These weeds are flattened. This is another signal box. Like I said, I don't know what any of this shit is. Is there a placard on the side of this? No. But this one is huge. I'm taller than a man. You already know what I'm about to do. Open it. Still some stuff in here. Yes. There are wasps in here. Look at this stuff. Yeah, boy. ~440! Exclamation mark. This is General Railway Signal Company. Excuse me. Back when things were still made in the USA. Okay, guys, I'm out of here. That's enough exploring for today.